Normally, when you insert an object, that object is a static object. Objects like the circles, the ellipses, the rectangles, etc. Now when you add things like ProcessBook trends and values, those are scriptable from the start. But if I wanted to give this a properties, if I wanted this to show up with properties enabled, I'd have to enable scripting. By choosing enable scripting, this gives this a set of properties I can manipulate programmatically. Also, when I enable scripting, like I'm going to do to this polygon, when I enable scripting, I can now associate scripts with that polygon. So let's take a look at the code window here. We're going to look for that polygon. Here it is. It's called polygon, and it has a click event. So I can say clicked polygon, and that is a script that is now associated with this polygon object. As you can see, I click on there, it runs the script. So ordinary objects can be scriptable. Now the reason by default they're not scriptable is because there is a certain amount of memory overhead with exposing the object model of these different objects. And in some displays there are hundreds and hundreds of these objects. We don't want to expose them all if they're not being used. Oh, incidentally, you can enable scripting to objects that are selected en masse. So I can select all these, choose enable scripting, and now all of these are available.